We're about to find out at this movie premiere.
Records for being the only British band to have their first four singles top the charts. Their debut album, Spice, selling over 18 million copies worldwide, and now
Scary, Baby, Ginger, Posh and Sporty
are about to hit Sydney.
That's right. Can you believe it? Can you believe it, Jade? I mean, it's times like these I really appreciate being a children's television host, don't you? Sit back and imagine where we are. Just think of it. Just think of it. We're at the Spice Girls premiere, man.
That's right, Ryan. We're out
here. Rubbing shoulders with the celebrities, huh?
Out here, Ryan, with the celebrities, out front of the State Theatre, where I can only think on this premiere eve that we have no tickets.
However, it will be resolved after we find a dropped one on the floor, won't we? We'll find one. And then we'll, you know, use our boy power to get inside.
Sure, Ryan. Well, let's try our boy power
on some of the fans.
Yes, the fans.
Sounds good. Let's go and talk to some of the fans then.
For some in the crowd, the next best thing to meeting the Spice Girls was Jade and Ryan from Cheese TV. It's a hard life, guys.
This can't be very hygienic. Hey, how are you, man?
Who's your favourite Spice?
Emma.
I want to know if a guy can name all five Spice Girls.
Jerry, Victoria, Melly B, Melly C and Emma.
Wow, that's very good. Ryan, this is supposed to be the Spice Girls. What are you doing?
Well, I'm the next best thing, man.
He reckons.
Who's your favourite Spice Girl?
Jerry! Emma! I think all of them are, but Emma's the best.
All right, go Emma!
Who's got a ticket to the show? You! She's a liar! Have you got a ticket to the show, really?
No.
Oh, no. Well, it was a good try anyway.
So, things aren't going too well for the boys. Let's take a look at the making of Spice World.
They are just like the most famous people in the, on the planet at the moment.
You better believe it!
Spice Girls are going to show you how to make a movie.
Here we go.
Spice Girls set to conquer the globe. Why is it that I can't pick up a paper without seeing them all over the front page?
Next Saturday, 8 o'clock, for the first time ever, the Spice Girls are going to perform live for the very first time here at the Albert Hall.
Well, we haven't had much luck getting into the movie. Although the celebrities should be arriving soon, and, well, I'm sure some of our friends will be amongst those. We'll see you after the break. Welcome back. We're at the premiere of Spice World, the movie, where everyone's been invited except for us.
Yeah, it's not fair, is it? Anyway, if you look around, Jade, you'll see so many cameras and reporters and people from the media. It's amazing, you know, because the whole movie is situated around five girls, Spice Girls, right? And it's very ironic because the movie is actually about their life with the paparazzi and all of that stuff.
Wow, man, that's really deep, Ryan. It's really deep.
Thought of it myself.
In the film, we wanted to show a lot of things that, you know, really do happen. And paparazzi photographers is a bane of our lives. Is that the right expression? They really are. They're everywhere. Do you know what I mean? And it's like, I mean, we take it to the extreme in the film, which you'll see, but it's like, you wonder when you go to bed at night whether there's one going to be hiding under your bed. Do you know what I mean? That is what they're like. They just seem to know where you're going to be and when you're going to be there. It's so bizarre.
Hi. I don't believe he's got a camera.
You're not with Paul, are you?
Emergency!
Oh, get back here, Melanie!
For the theatre!
Go and get it, Melanie!
Follow me. Fellow Channel 10 personality, Jodie, how you going?
No, yeah, not bad.
Now, I believe you've got a ticket for tonight?
Yes, I do, as a matter of fact, yes.
Can we have a photocopy?
Who are you?
Ryan Lappin from Cheese TV. That's Jade Gadd, my counterpart.
Ah, I don't think so, fellas.
Come on, Ryan.
Even if you've never heard of the Spice Girls, I think you will enjoy it because it's very entertaining and it feels good while we're making it, so if that means anything. But I think it'll be great.
5 days in the life of us, working up to a big live performance at the end of it. You know, there's lots of different parts to the film. You know, it's fun. There's some fun parts, there's some serious parts, there's some action parts, there's some romantic parts. You know, it's just loads and loads of things going on. It's going to be good fun. There's bright colours.
It's a parody of our lives, and it is. That's the whole thing. It is very true to us lot. Yes, even slightly exaggerated, but not quite, you know, it is pretty real, some of the stuff. I mean, we're a bunch of, you know, loca chicas, crazy girls.
Okay, horoscopes!
I don't believe star signs.
You see, you wouldn't, because you're an Aquarian. Aquarians don't believe in anything.
Well, I don't believe that either.
Oh, no, I can't find my boots. I think I've lost them.
It's always the same. I never know what to wear.
Yeah, it must be really hard for you, Victoria. You know, Charles decides whether to wear the little Gucci dress, the little Gucci dress, or the little Gucci dress.
Exactly.
I know. Why don't you wear the little Gucci dress?
Oh, that's a good idea. Thanks, Em.
Typical, typical Leo that is, isn't it? Borrowing stuff without even asking me.
No, that's Capricorn.
Oi, don't you be starting on Capricorns.
That's it, you've had it.
Oi, have it back! No, I don't want it! Get off!
Excuse me!
What do you think of this one?
Great!
Angela, excuse me. Hey, come over here. 5 minutes. Hello, good, how are you?
Got a ticket tonight?
Yes, I do.
Really?
Now, is there anything we could do to persuade you for it?
No, I don't think so. I think this is the opportunity of a lifetime, and I'm going to use it.
Oh, come on, man. Hey, you remember the Beatles, don't you?
Yeah, I remember the Beatles.
What do you think of the Beatles compared to the Spice Girls, eh?
They were boys.
Oh, I see. So you want to give us a ticket or not?
No.
Oh, thanks anyway.
Thank you.
That's okay.
Hope to see you inside.
Yeah.
Great.
How did you acquire your tickets to such an event?
Wheeling and dealing, a bit of that.
Friends of friends.
Oh, friends of friends, eh? Now, is there anything we could do to persuade you to give us your tickets?
No, not in your life.
Nothing?
No, nothing.
Gotta go see Ginger.
Yeah.
Ginger?
Good old Ginger.
Yeah, I know Ginger.
I'd like to see Ginger.
Good mates. Ginger.
You?
Yeah.
Why didn't you tell me?
I don't know.
You've got to tell us how you acquired tickets to such an event.
Well, we stayed here.
You slept out for the tickets to the Spice Girls.
Yes, we did.
Unbelievable.
Where would we get some tickets?
Sorry, I think they're all gone.
Hey, you wouldn't want to give us... All right.
I thought they'd be selling them at the door.
We're in. We did it. We're in. Ryan, come back.
Well, it turned out to be a dud. It's a receipt, man. It's not worth nothing.
You're right. We're going to have to keep trying, Ryan.
Yes. Yes, yes. Trying.
Hello?
We've got to get some tickets. We've got to get in. We don't have tickets.
Have they arrived?
They haven't arrived yet.
All right. Tips up to date, all right?
We will. Take care, brother. All right. The best. Later. Hello there. How are you doing?
I'm great, thank you.
Now, how did you acquire tickets to such an event?
How did I acquire? Didn't you know?
No.
I'm Crutchless Spice.
Crutchless Spice!
Keep trying, boys. Maybe they should do what a lot of fans did and dress up as their favourite Spice.
You guys are just looking pretty smart.
I know.
I reckon we look like Reservoir Dogs. I can be Mr. Pink.
That's right, all the schmickers people.
Hey, man. You
made our job. Now, is there any chance we could get your ticket off your Maynard?
Yeah. No, well, look, I got two here. There's one for me and another guy, but there's no way. Yeah.
No way.
I'm giving that ticket up.
Oh,
we're hoping to get them in the door.
I've got a date with Posh Spice. This is about as close as I'm going to get to it, too. Yeah.
Beautiful.
What do you reckon?
You look great.
Old Spice or Crappy Spice?
I think it's Old Spice.
I'll see you guys later. Okay?
Goodbye, mate.
It's good to see you moving up in the world, you guys.
Well, I for one are very disappointed. We didn't even get one ticket to one customer.
I know, Ryan. And it seems there's not as many celebrities as I thought there would be here. Although, I guess the Spice Girls have given it to their fans.
Yeah.
We're going to keep trying, though. We're going to get some tickets.
We'll go down fighting.
Hello, Mr. Bond. Or can I call you Jay? Well, that shake no stirred.
That's it. I'm off going.
When they ran out of famous people, they did the next best thing and mimicked each other. There's no stopping that girl power.
My mummy's my best friend. I'm just too posh.
When a little fork and win the cook line, Dave.
Oh, we've finished yet. Blah, 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 girl power, feminism, do you know what I mean?
I've been strangled. How do you feel?
Really uncomfortable.
Well, I just didn't fill up these shoes. You explain my ankle.
These things are really tight. They're going right on my bum.
These are really comfy, actually.
You don't need to think about it, do you?
I'm off. I'm getting these off. Oh, I need some black ones.
How can you wear these?
Look apart apart from my clothes anyway.
Attention is mounting because the Spice Girls are about to arrive on a double-decker bus. They're going to be doing their thing, and tension is really mounting. They have 150 security guards for this event, numerous police, mounted police. It's just a buzz. Check that out.
Wow.
Richard E. Grant, who's playing Clifford, his character, is, I just love it. It is fantastic. He's all irate and annoyed and uptight and frustrated with everything and anyone around him. I just think it's hysterical. He's really uptight, like stiff.
Yes, Chief.
How are the girls, Clifford? Ready for showtime on Saturday?
Just going to rehearsals. They're hot, Chief. They've got fire in their eyes, hunger in their bellies, and great big shoes on their feet. I'm telling you, Chief.
Well, remember that now is the dangerous time. They've had a lot of success very quickly. So get ready for the backlash.
There's certainly no sign of a backlash here, as Sporty, Scary, Baby, Ginger and Posh make their way through an ecstatic crowd. We've seen the Spice Girl cakes, biscuits, body spray, pizzas and dolls, but at last their adoring public have the real thing. Having waited for hours, photographers, journalists and fans are all desperate to get the attention of their top Spice Girl. But it's only the experienced few who'll make that magic contact.
It's them! And they're walking this way! We lost them in this little crowd here. Hey. Whoa. Help! Hello! Hey! How do you like Australia? Do you like it up there?
The fans are fantastic.
The beaches are nice, aren't they?
Fantastic.
Oh, thank you.
Good luck! Spice, talking about Australia. Wow, what a privilege, eh? Let's go and see if we can talk to someone else. Come on. We've got to do something, man. They can't stop me. I'm from the media.
Media and fans alike were held back as the girls were showered with teddy bears and flowers. With the last few waves to the crowd, it's time to say goodbye and take their seats for Spice World the movie. We'll be right back. With time running out, Jay decides to try one last time for a ticket to the movie premiere of Spice World.
And we're actually looking for tickets, and we know you've got some, and we're wondering if we could have them.
Certainly we can.
You can.
Yes! That's great! Yes! Finally! Check they're real, Ryan. It's not a receipt.
Wait.
We got tickets. We got them. Thanks, guys.
Together, it was something that we wanted to do. We said to ourselves, we're not just a band, we want to try everything.
I really need some great actors in the film, and I was thinking about, you know, Richard E. Grant.
Jerry and Emma said, you are going to be in this film, aren't you? I said, yes, of course.
Clifford is neurotic.
Look at that! More stories, more evil harpoons from the press.
It's all lies, I tell you, bring me a straight jacket!
He plays like our manager.
He has very little power, and gets stomped over by them.
From now on, there's no more Mr. Nice Spice.
I'm playing Piers Gutterson Smythe, who's trying to make a documentary about the Spices.
Come on, boys, capture that magic.
But he has very little success, because he is pretty dippy.
So what I want to do with this documentary is show the real Spice Girls.
It's like we're really intensive, trying to make a really hard-hitting documentary, and then we really craft it.
You know, I want to break through the showbiz facade. I want to crash right through it and reveal the truth.
Well, that's fine. Just as long as you crash through the showbiz facade on schedule and don't get in anybody's way.
The film is self-parodying, and the girls, you know, are very good at, you know, taking the mickey out of themselves and having fun with the whole Spice Girls thing that's going on, the whole phenomenon.
You don't have a life. You have a schedule. You are part of a well-oiled global machine. There are people everywhere working their butts off for you.
The girls cannot have the morning off.
Sorry, Chief, just an idea.
It's all glamour and that. It's all really lovely and they treat you really well.
We've been shooting now for 42 days. The girls are never off screen. They've been very professional. We've kept absolutely to schedule.
The schedule is so tight we even have to rehearse in the dressing room.
Which is remarkable. And, you know, they've given me everything I could ask for, basically, in just, you know, their natural talent and professionalism.
A usual day filming is up at the crack of dawn, 6.
We all come in with wet hair, no makeup, looking absolutely lovely. And then, once we're all done, we go on to film and we're ready for the day.
Have you done this before?
Oh, no more.
Well, this one.
You're a bit long, aren't you?
And sometimes it's really quick and sometimes it goes on and on and on.
But we do it and we get through it because we've got girl power.
To save the day, and I had to drive the bus zooming around London, which was a lot of fun.
We always wanted to go out and conquer the world, and it was like, it's a bit of a joke really, do you know what I mean? And we're just pushing it to the boundaries and seeing how far we can go.
I can make it happen, Brad! Me, Kevin McMaxford, I put them up there, I can bring them down! Yes!
It does represent that we have been hounded from day one by the press. On the end of the day, you know, the press are part of our lives.
Thank you very much.
And now Emma is demonstrating how to deal with intrusive photographers. The rest is on. Get out of
the bathroom. That's good! Do it again!
Fantastic. I find that hysterical!
I think you're bad, it's not as hard as me.
At the end of the day, I mean, it's us, that's the way I am Baby Spice. You know, even though we discuss it in the thing, I don't mean I don't like being Baby Spice, just that, you know, because I'm always the cutesy one. And it's nice, because that's who I am. But sometimes I can be hard as well.
But I think quite a few people are going to be surprised when they see, you know, see the film, because even though, like, we're our own characters, they've been taken to the max. And funny enough, I smile a few times in this film, so it's a bit of an exclusive there.
Jerry was the one that organised what characters we should be.
Yeah,
look at Jerry. And it looks.
All the characters that we chose are basically the ones that we admire, but also fitting with us, I think.
This is the actual costume that Wonder Woman wore. But I think she had a smaller waist than me.
You know, everything we've done in this film, you know, with the script, you know, the characters that we've chosen, the songs that we've decided to put it, always comes from us.
Paul Ryan, looks like there's one thing left to do, huh?
That's right. Jaden Ryan, yeah?
Yeah.
Come again. Stand right through, the girl's waiting for you.
Thanks very much.
All right. Thank you. Have a good night.
Action Alien.
Action Alien.
This is the Royal Albert Hall, and it will soon be filled with more screaming children.
The day we did the live concert was absolutely amazing.
Everything's really quite normal to us. It's just everybody on the outside going a bit, whoa!
Then we walked out on the stage, and everybody just went absolutely berserk.
But, I mean, the amazing thing is they are completely, you know, relatively unaffected by it all. When you're feeling...